What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about three practical ways that you can stop overthinking inside of the game of business. Now, inside the container of Wake Up Wealthy, right, we're a high performance coaching program for male entrepreneurs. And we see a lot of men come in from a variety of different backgrounds, skill sets, income levels, et cetera. And one of the most common things that we find is that a lot of men and people in general really suffer from overthinking, habitual thoughts that they can't stop. And what we end up finding out is that overthinking actually is a massive drain on your energy. And as a result of it being a massive drain on your energy, it's a massive drain on your creativity, on your willpower, on your ability to execute, on your ability to stay present and connected to what's actually going on. And so overthinking is something that plagues a lot of people. And so in this video, I want to dive in and talk about three practical ways that that you can reduce the amount of overthinking, or, you know, generally just stop it for the most part. And it's not easy. It takes time and it takes practice, but let's go ahead and dive right in. And so the first way to stop overthinking is to actually reduce something or eliminate something. It's letting go of perfectionism. See, perfectionism is one of those things that unfortunately gets instilled in a lot of, you know, people as they're growing up, whether it's from family members, their mom or dad, coaches, whatever, placing these unrealistic expectations on them, which creates this aspect of their personality where things need to be absolutely perfect in order for them to feel good about doing something or putting something out or making a decision. And the reality is that perfectionism is totally an illusion. There's no such thing as perfect. Everybody starts somewhere and everybody's learning and everybody's on a different path. When you're constantly operating under the pretense of everything has to be perfect before I take action or before I make a decision, then you're gonna get stuck. You're gonna get caught in this overthinking loop where you're constantly analyzing and judging and worrying and wondering how something is gonna look or how something is gonna perform. And that totally limits your ability to be present and to take action. So work on letting go of perfectionism and understand that perfectionism oftentimes isn't actually even a thing. It's not even about having things be perfect. The underlying, typically, root of perfectionism is actually has to do with either an insecurity or a fear of maybe embarrassment or a fear of rejection or a fear of failure. And so being able to look at that and say, okay, well, I understand I'm overthinking a lot, but what's the specific cause of it? Well, I'm overthinking in this specific scenario because, you know, I want this to be perfect and I don't want it to, you know, be fucked up or whatever when I put it out there. And if you continue to peel back the layers of the onion, you'll find out that that actually comes from some deeper level of fear that that the person may be resisting or hasn't come to terms with. And so letting go of perfectionism is going to be a really powerful way for you to stop overthinking so that you can just take action and just be okay with where you're at, whatever the circumstance is, and to simply just move forward. So that's the first one. So the second way to stop overthinking is to set clear intentions and to have clarity on the path, the process, or the outcome. So that's a big one, right? A lot of us don't set intentions. A lot of us aren't really clear on what the next steps are. And we don't necessarily have a path that we're following, right? A lot of people just kind of wake up and we kind of go throughout our day and whatever comes up, we just kind of attend to that. And then we do the next thing and we do the next thing. And so as a result of not having our next steps clearly defined, as a result of not having clear intentions, and intentions are basically just a declared outcome, right? In the infinite number of possibilities and choices that exist in the present moment, an intention is your ability to take a step back and to set a specific type of outcome that you would like for things to unfold as. And so when you don't set intentions and you don't have clarity, then you're going to be in your head, right? You're going to be in your head judging and wondering and worrying and constantly trying to assess like what's going on now and what's going to happen in the future, right? Whereas if you take a step back and you set clear intentions and you take some time to really create some clarity for yourself, then you're not going to need to be in your head as much. You're not going to need to be constantly overthinking because you know where you're going, right? And so when you know where you're going, then at that point it's just about executing and operating according to that path. And then the third and final thing that we're going to talk about, which I talk about a lot and you guys are probably sick of hearing me talk about, is meditation, right? Meditation is such a powerful activity and exercise, and it is a dramatic help when it comes to reducing the amount of thinking and overthinking that we might, you know, habitually engage in on a regular basis. Because what you're doing is, right, in a normal day-to-day setting, you're going to be going out about your day, things are going to come up, you're going to have to deal with them, you're going to be reactive, and so you're going to constantly be in your head, right? The average person has like 60,000 thoughts a day. When you meditate, what you're doing is you're taking specific amounts of time, let's say in as little as 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes at a time, you're going into a space where you are intentionally, and there's a lot of different, you know, techniques for meditation, but you're intentionally trying to, let's say, just focus on your breath. And as a result of just intentionally focusing only on your breath for the next 5, 10, 15 minutes, naturally, you're gonna start thinking less. And this is where a lot of people get tripped up with meditation. It's like they don't think they're doing meditation right because they can't get themselves to stop thinking. And so it becomes this really just this difficult exercise that's not fun because they feel like they're doing it wrong. And that's okay. Like the point of meditation isn't to just go into a space where you are totally blank for 15 minutes. In fact, that's mostly impossible, right? It's like throughout that period of meditation, you're gonna have periods of time where the mind sort of quiets and you begin to get very, very relaxed. And you might have that gap of 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 15 seconds where you are just totally connected to the present moment and it feels like there's no thoughts, right? And then you might start thinking for 30 seconds, a minute, 2 minutes, and all of a sudden 3 minutes have passed by and you went down this rabbit hole. But the point of meditation is to notice that and to bring yourself back to the present moment. And so understand that with meditation, what you're doing is you are training your mind to slow down. You are training your mind to become more calm. And so when you do this repeatedly, days at a time, weeks at a time, and if you can stay consistent with it, months at a time, you find that the overall internal dialogue, your overall conscious experience of life totally changes because you find that you just become a lot more present. You become a lot more grounded. You become a lot more connected to the present moment for what it is, unobstructed by thoughts, unobstructed by stories and labels and judgments. And that becomes a very practical tool to stop the overthinking. And so as we look back, right, three practical ways to stop overthinking, whether it's inside of the game of business, a lot of what we talk about here inside of Wake Up Wealthy is for entrepreneurs and professionals, but this works for anybody, right, at any stage of their life. And so number one, letting go of perfection, realizing that perfection is an illusion and that be willing, be okay to just start where you're at and to just take action and move forward and understand that things will never be perfect. Number two, set intentions and have clear goals. Really take some time to slow down and look at like the process, right? What are all the steps involved? What's the path? What's the process? And have some clarity around that. Because once you set intentions and once you have clarity, then at that point, you can just move forward and execute, and you don't have to be in your head constantly judging and worrying and creating stories. And last but not least, the third way is to meditate. And we've got tons of videos on meditation. In fact, if you click out of this video, once you're done, we've got tons of videos on meditation, on business, on a lot of different things focused around mindset and performance. And so check some of those videos out if you want to learn more about, you know, how we look at the mind and how we look at performance inside of the container of business and entrepreneurship here at Wake Up Wealthy. All right, we'll see you in the next video.